Imagine you are sending a secret message to your friend who lives far away. You write the message down on a piece of paper and put it in an envelope. You give the envelope to the postman and he sends it to your friend. When your friend receives the envelope, she opens it and reads the message. Now, imagine you want to send a message to your friend, but this time it's not a secret. You want to send a lot of information, like a video or a music file. It's too big to fit in one envelope, so you need to break it up into smaller pieces. You put each piece in a separate envelope and give them to the postman. He sends them all to your friend, who receives them one by one. When she has all the pieces, she can put them together to see the full video or hear the full song. This is how datagrams work in the computer world. They are like small envelopes that contain a piece of information, such as a video or music file. When you send a large file over the internet, it is broken up into many datagrams. Each datagram has a header that tells the computer where it came from and where it's going. The datagrams are sent over the internet and reassembled on the receiving end. One cool thing about datagrams is that they don't need to be confirmed. When you send an email, you want to know that it has been received by the person you sent it to. But when you're streaming a video, it doesn't matter if every single datagram is received. As long as most of them get through, the video will play smoothly. This makes datagrams perfect for streaming services, where the most important thing is to keep the data flowing. So, remember, datagrams are small envelopes of information that can be sent over the internet. They are used for streaming services, where the constant flow of data is more important than 100% accuracy.